All right, we're testing twin telepathy. Touch an ear. Smile big. Shake your head. Do a jumping jack.
And I want to sneeze.
Show me your best dance move. Okay. Pretend to jump rope. Blow a kiss.
Why does your face
Pretend to climb a ladder. Gosh. Okay. Touch your toes. Skip in place. Pretend to catch a ball. Strike a model pose. Okay. Act shocked. Pretend a fake laugh. Shoot a basketball. Oh my gosh. Okay. A zombie is attacking you. Pretend to swim.
Good night, too. Night showers, former Girl Scouts, people who enjoy buying socks, dog lovers, those who had a fifth grade graduation, the chapstick obsessed, anyone who doesn't know their social security number, those who own a pair of Crocs, low-key teachers' pets, people who miss the lime Skittle, those who used to play Wepkins, theater kids, people who still take gummy vitamins, nervous peers, those who have never seen Grey's Anatomy, and anyone with an unnecessary amount of sweatshirts.
Tonight the super trooper lights are gonna find me shining like the sun.
Sorry for wasting your time.
Wait, please don't leave. This cost me so much money.
I am so sorry.
He's walking out. Just like your father did.
Wait a minute, I didn't tell you about that.
Didn't have to. Like nothing ever happened at all. At
all. I think we should treat the Barbie movie like the MCU and make men watch every Barbie animated movie first before seeing the live action one like. You haven't seen Barbie Nutcracker? You don't know Bibble? Okay, fake fan. You actually won't understand the plot unless you've seen the entire Barbie life in the Dreamhouse series. You won't get the lore. Okay, but do I need to play Barbie Horse Adventures Wild Horse Rescue, or is that in a different chronology? Yes, of course that's required. If you were a real Barbie fan, you could name at least 5 fairies from Barbie Fairytopia. Sing every song from Princess and the Pauper before entering the theater. You're just like me. You're just like me. Do you not even know the basic lore? Oh, I get it. You're just here with your girlfriend, right? Exactly. You like the Barbie movies? Name 5 limited edition Barbie doll releases. Get married to Written in Your Heart and then we'll talk. Honestly, if you haven't seen Barbie Princess and the Pauper, you shouldn't be granted tickets. Can't watch the Barbie movie unless you played the PC CD-ROM game where she goes scuba diving for treasure. Every time I got to the game ending as a kid, it would crash before it would finish. I still have no idea how that game ends or what it was called again. You wouldn't get it unless you know the lyrics to A Girl Like You from Princess and Pauper completely by heart. I still say cheeky blighter in a terrible English accent on the regular, and nobody gets that it's a reference to the animated Barbie Nutcracker movie. Me entering theaters having watched Barbie Extended Universe and played the games as a kid. Bring it on. What are the 12 dancing princesses flowers? You're not allowed in the theater unless you've played at least 15 hours of Barbie horse riding camp. How are you supposed to understand the second end credit flower drop without seeing 12 dancing princesses? Fake fans, Bibble is key Barbie lore like get with the program people. You don't know about Raquel? Fake fan. The games, too. Can't miss Detective Barbie and the Mystery of the Carnival Caper. It'll have important backstory for sure.
Nothing very
Which reminds me. Please, someone come and rescue me. And I also have like minor baby synesthesia, so when I listen to songs, I'll like see colors, and lots of the songs on Sour are purple, like Driver's License is purple, but Good For You is like a purpley blue, Jealousy Jealousy is like bright red, Deja Vu is like orange and pink and light purple.
I was gonna say Deja Vu was orange.
Yeah, yeah. It's like lighter, more pastel-y, and I like having purple as the cohesive color throughout my whole Sour era.
Can't make people do right by you, but you have the power to decide when you're not going to let people do you wrong anymore. Enough is enough.
Let's try Blake Lively's canned cocktail line. The flavors sound really unique. Sparkling bourbon with apple ginger sour cherry.
Also, shout out to my nails. They're by a brand called Ohora. They're like press-ons, but way better.
I am most curious about this flavor. Apparently there's butter in it. Butter. Sparkling tequila with oak smoked lemonade. Doesn't have butter in the ingredients, but Blake Lively said, she said there's butter in here. So they're butter, B. Sparkling tequila with lime shisho. Shiso? Shisho. She's so pretty. Oh my God, this is awkward. We're wearing the same thing. You should change. Here's the part you're not gonna like. A 4-pack of these is $15. $3.75 per drink. That sounds expensive. However, if you go to a bar and order a sparkling bourbon with apple ginger sour cherry, it's gonna cost you like $20, and it's probably gonna take 15 minutes for the bartender with a handlebar mustache to make. You know who you are. Let's try it. Here we go. Oh, that's delicious. Oh man, I love this. There is this little tart cherry moment. The bourbon is very light. Chuggability on this is off the chart. Can I chug it? Yes. Would I buy it again? Yes. It's a 9.5. Sue, sparkling tequila with lime shiso. It's like opening a can of me, you know? Who wore it better? Don't answer that. Don't answer that. Here we go. Oh, okay, that's a little funky. You know, like if grass were a cocktail, it'd be this. I mean, dogs have been eating it for years. I'll give this one a 6. Okay, and then the one that I'm the most curious about, Betty Boo's Butter. Here we go. Oh my God, it smells like popcorn. Better not taste like popcorn. Although, whoa, whoa. It's like lemon pie, like a lemon bar. That's what it tastes like. Oh my God, this is the best. So weird. Buttery, creamy, lemony, fruity, tarty, square. Because lemon bars are square. It's like a buttery lemon tart, but it's not overly sweet. It's still 11. I'm not sure about the oak and smoke part. I don't know what they were oak smoking when they put butter in this. Okay, these two were delicious. I would absolutely try them again. If you want something so out there but delicious, this is your girl. Okay, you know you love me. XOXO, Seltzert girl.
These are TV characters that I think would be LGBTQ+ if the show were created in 2023. Number one, Peyton Sawyer from One Tree Hill. I am a huge supporter of Leighton, Lucas and Peyton. I definitely think that they are meant to be. I do think, however, that in 2023, Peyton's character would be bi. She just gave off so much queer energy to me, and I also deeply related with her, which I feel like in her relationship with Lucas, she was the more mask energy one and he was the femme energy one. Next up, Jenny Humphrey from Gossip Girl after she gets into her like rebellious era. I think the sweet Jenny Humphrey in the beginning is like her in the closet. And then when she liberates herself and turns into this, she would be like pan, bi, queer, like just fluid. Also from Gossip Girl, Chuck Bass. If his love story with Blair hadn't been so compelling, I would just think that he was gay and had a lot of internalized homophobia that manifested in the form of him sleeping around and having a lot of meaningless relationships with women. But considering his relationship with Blair, I would say that in 2023, he would be pansexual. I mean, come on, this is not straight guy energy. It's just not. Next up on the list, Phoebe Buffay from Friends. I mean, look at her style. She's even got rings on every finger. I know Phoebe ends up with a guy in the end, Paul Rudd, but I think in 2023, she would have been a lesbian. Her whole aesthetic, her whole vibe was just not like straight girl vibes. And she kissed Rachel, and I know she said, "I've had better," but like, what does that mean? Maybe she's had better with women. This one is going back a ways, like 20 years, but Angela from Boy Meets World. I will die on this hill. Angela would be queer. I mean, look at her style, look at the flannel. Not only did I have a crush on her on Boy Meets World, but like, yes, of course. This is not a straight girl. This is not a straight girl. This would have made Lost a lot more interesting. Kate, I mean, look at the, are you kidding me? This is like the ultimate mask fashion right here. Well, it's like survival mask fashion. But like, can you imagine how good that show would have been? I mean, it was a great show, but if she'd been bi, queer, pan, like, oh my God. This one is probably going to divide some people, and that's okay. Damon Salvatore. Damon Salvatore is just sexual. He's just very sexual. And I do not think that he would have lived 200 years or whatever without hooking up with a single man. I think he probably would have had a male lover, especially in his early 1900s era. I just think he's fluid. I think he'd be fluid.
Once Upon a Time got it right when they made this character that is usually a hero, a villain. If you think you know the character I'm talking about, pause and tell me now, or press my picture if you want more TV analysis. Obviously, I think we can all agree that Once Upon a Time fell off a little bit, but my absolute favorite season is this one where they turned a hero into a villain. Because let's be honest, some heroes in the Disney movies are villains. Let's do this like my wholesome movies that are actually horror movie series, and I'm just gonna explain to you this character and you tell me if he's wholesome or not. The entire job of this character is to find children who feel like they do not belong in the world and then take them to a land where they are going to be frozen in time. Otherwise, frozen forever as a child who is lost. But this land where time is frozen is also not safe. It's got grown men who want to hurt the children. It doesn't have enough resources to the point that they don't even have food for the kids. And the only way that the kids are able to eat is if they imagine food exists and then like eat air. And the only way to get off of this land is to find pixie dust, which again, it's not just around. It's just not available to every kid. I don't know, that sounds like a nightmare to me, but are you really gonna say that Peter Pan is a hero? Nope, nuh-uh.
Breaking gay news.
I could go to jail for 15 years.
A federal judge nominated by Donald Trump just ruled.
Can't say I didn't try.
That Tennessee's ban on drag shows.
No, you're really beautiful.
Pretty boy, you.
Restricts free speech and is now under restraining order.
I'm not a feminist.
Oh, I am.
I'm not a feminist. I can wear dresses and feel pretty.
I'm a feminist and I wear dresses and skirts and pants or whatever makes me feel the most beautiful and confident.
Not a feminist. I can actually cook.
I'm a feminist. I can cook, but I'm not obligated to. I cook when I'm in the mood. You know who else can cook? My husband. But if neither of us have the energy or capacity one night, then we're serving frozen pizza.
Not a feminist. I don't hate children.
I'm a feminist and a mom and much more. I love my two children and I'm grateful to not be defined by them.
I'm not a feminist. Thank you.
I'm a feminist. Let's all just hold the door open for whoever comes in next.
I'm a feminist. And then people ask me if I'm actually a woman.
I'm a feminist and I am so grateful for the women and men who have paved the way and continue to work for modern feminism, where all people have equal rights and the opportunity to create lives and relationships that are unique to them.
Do you guys ever think about dying?
When my heart breaks.
Some things have been happening that might be related.
When my world shakes.
Cold shower.
Ooh.
Falling off my roof.
Ah!
And my heels are on the ground.
Have to do.
You have to go
to the real world.
You can go back to your regular life, or you can know the truth about the universe.
The choice is now yours.
The first one, the high heel.
You have to want to know, okay? Do it again.
Frank wants to know, who is your dream collaboration? Who would you love to work with?
The top of my list is Lil Baby.
Okay, a lot of people have been asking me how I do my hair like this, and I figured I would show you guys how to do it today. I do this hairstyle all the time, probably because it works when my hair is clean, when it's dirty, all the things. And it's really quick and easy. So my hair is freshly washed right now. That's why it looks like this. And the first thing I'm gonna do is just part it. I part it down the middle and the top and the back. No, I don't do anything fancy. I don't use a comb or anything. I literally just use my fingers and I'll just like it's already kind of parted down the middle. So I'll just like kind of keep going and then get it all the way down the back. Split it in two. Obviously not using this side to start, so I just pull it out of the way. Once I have this half, I just pull a little section out in the front so I have a little bit of face framing. And then I pull a little tiny section on the top and split it in two like this. Then what you're gonna do is take the front piece and twist it over the back piece like that. And then literally all you do is you add hair to this bottom piece and then you twist it over the top again. And you just keep doing that. So you just add hair as you go, only to the one piece. You don't add it to both sides, just to the one piece as you twist it back. And you just continually pull that piece over the other one all the way back. This is the little bit tricky part. So you're gonna get to the end where you don't have any more hair to add and you've got these two pieces. If you don't twist them together correctly, they will just unravel. So the best way to twist them, and I always think about this, is to twist them like opposite. So you're gonna go like this with your hands, twist like this, and you're gonna twist like that and then twist them together. So twist together. Twist together, if that makes sense. See how it stays twisted when I let it go? It's because you do the fancy little twist thing. Anyway, now all I do is I just take these little twisted pieces and I just pull them out so they look a little fluffier around my face and my head. I'm gonna repeat on the other side and show you the finished result. That's how I do this hairstyle.
Today is Purim, which is the Jewish dress-up and candy holiday, otherwise known as my favorite holiday. So let me tell you a little bit about it. The story of Purim pretty much has the same base of every Jewish holiday. It's the same. People wanted to kill us, but then they didn't end up killing us. So now we have parties and we eat food, which is great for us. One of the reasons why we wear costumes is because God was doing a bunch of hidden miracles. So we hide ourselves with costumes. And I've always been a dress-up girly. So I have never stopped. And I try to get a little creative with my costumes. I'll show you mine when I'm done with my face. Purim is one of the most joyous Jewish holidays. People say that you're actually supposed to get so drunk that you mix up the like hero character from the evil character from the story, which I mean I personally don't drink, so I don't take that one, but a lot of people do. But it's all in good fun. There is the piece about getting drunk, having fun, making parties, but it's also a very giving holiday. We're supposed to make shalach manot or mishloach manot, which are packages of food that we give out to all of our friends and our community. And it's really great because it gives people food if they're in need, but it's also just, I want to make a fun package and give it to my friends, so it's cute. But then we also have Matanos Lavionim, which is giving money to people in need. So we give the money to our rabbi, and he sends it to poor people in the community, or a a charity that our synagogue or shul is funding.
Now for my costume, I am being Baby from Dirty Dancing. Here are my inspiration pictures. My goal was to thrift my entire costume, and I did, and I'm so proud of myself because it's so good. Let me show you. My goal with my perm costumes are usually to get pieces that I can actually see myself wearing besides perm, because what's the point in spending more money on things that I will only wear one day, except for if it's like a wedding dress. So this sweater was perfect, and I thrifted this perfect dress. It is also Tommy Hilfiger, and it's just literally, I saw it, and I can never find dresses at thrift stores, and I saw it and it's like angels started singing. So I also have some light tights that I'm gonna put on and some flats, and so let me put it on my body. This is the costume, and it is so beyond perfect. I've thrifted this, I thrifted the dress, the shoes I already have, they're from Vivia. This I already had, it's called Gaia, I won it in a giveaway. It's for the watermelon, because in the scene she carries a watermelon. I love it so much. The reason why perm is my favorite holiday is not just because of the costumes, though those are really fun, and it's not just because of the candy, it's because it's a day where you're literally supposed to forget about everything else, and you're supposed to try to be as happy as possible. It doesn't matter what's happening in the world. This is a day for just the Jewish people to be happy, and for you to be happy, and it's just, it's really nice. And yeah, so Chag Sameach, happy Purim, or just have a good day.
This might have been the quickest I've ever given up on taking self-portraits. Look at this wind. These sunflowers have been blooming in my backyard and I've been dying to shoot with them, but clearly I picked the wrong day to take photos. We started off strong, I hooked up my camera to my iPad and I climbed on in, not realizing that the stems were prickly and that there were bees everywhere. Something definitely bit me, but I don't know what it was. Once I started moving around, I got a shot I was super happy with, but then when I went to move my tripod, it started getting windy as hell and the flowers were going everywhere, and I was so itchy that I just gave up. I spent 11 minutes shooting and only took 26 photos total, but I got this shot. I love it.